Here's what a lot of people don't understand about healthcare, and thinking that, you know, at some point single payer is going to work much better. And listen, I've been a left leaning guy forever, but this is what people don't understand about capitation. And capitation is when you, instead of paying doctors or hospitals for services, you pay hospital groups to take care of populations, which is ultimately a great idea. But here's what people don't understand. They say, oh, it's going to be great. There will be competition and there will be innovation. But this is the thing. The only people that get the opportunity to manage a population of people, who's going to say, okay, these people get to run this state or that state, or even if they carve it into smaller cuts, than that, which they probably won't. Who's going to run those? Large organizations. Who doesn't innovate? Large organizations. So even if we go to single payer, you're still going to have a capitation model that's going to be dominated by large players. And large players at this point, they will incrementally improve results. They will. But the breakthroughs in health and well-being aren't going to come from the large organizations that are going to have the opportunity to participate in capitation. That's what people don't understand. Those contracts are going to go to big companies. And what are those big companies interested in? They're interested in keeping their cash flows right where they are and increasing them. And government seems to be ongoingly happy to align to that and say, oh, it's okay. Costs are going to go up over time. The small innovative companies won't be able to break into a system like that. So that's what we've got to deal with, is this idea that it's going to get better by mashing it all together. We tried that with the ACA, with the Affordable Care Act and Obamacare. They put everybody together and then they look to divide costs somewhat equally. How did that work out? Is people that were healthier don't want to carry the bills of unhealthy people. And all this is talking about budgets and dividing of costs. What it's missing is the fact that in many cases, there's still, in the vast majority of cases, there's still people getting sick that don't need to get sick. The approaches to wellness and well-being are so limited, it's mind-boggling. So that's where we individuals who care how long we're healthy, who care what we're doing, need to have more control over how our money is invested for our health and well-being. We need to be able to educate ourselves and support the education of the people with whom we share views so that we can stay healthier longer. And ultimately, right now, the people that we are trusting to do this thinking for us are not focusing on what we're focusing on. They're focusing on a system that delivers services for illness. That's the entire system. And if you think that that's going to instantly change because we go to Medicare to a Medicare for all system, well, even with capitation that has some competitiveness to it, it's going to be incredibly, incredibly slow. And during that time of locking out of services into what it is that your current insurance company say is okay or not okay, what are you going to have? You're going to have people like me paying out of pocket for the vast majority of services and having no opportunity to find a private source that can give us the opportunity to do healing in a different way. And that's what I'm working on. So there's my rant for the day. Cheers.